The White House reaches a tentative deal to avoid a rail strike that risked major disruptions across the U.S. The deal between major U.S. railroads and unions was reached after about 20 hours of talks, brokered by Labor Secretary Marty Walsh. Workers agreed not to hold a strike while the deal goes to a vote over the next week. This avoided a stoppage that could have started Friday. If the parties accept the deal, workers whose pay had been frozen would win double-digit increases and would be allowed to seek certain types of medical care without fear of being punished. The agreement also includes an immediate 14% wage rise.
The threat of a global recession is growing. That's according to the latest World Bank study. As major central banks hike rates to fight stubborn inflation, the World Bank says the global economy is in the middle of one of the most internationally synchronous episodes of monetary and fiscal policy tightening of the past five decades. It notes while such policy actions are necessary to contain inflation, their compounding effects may have larger impacts than intended, both in tightening financial conditions and steepening the growth slowdown by next year. World Bank President David Malpass is now urging policymakers to shift their focus from reducing consumption to boosting production to avoid lasting consequences of policy tightening. Inflation worldwide has been rising at the fastest pace in decades due to supply constraints, which were exacerbated this year by the Russian invasion of Ukraine and COVID lockdowns in China.
The Philippine province of Cavite awards the $11 billion contract to develop the Sandy Point International Airport to a multinational consortium. The SPIA Development Consortium is composed of companies from the Philippines, South Korea, and Europe, including Cavitex Holdings, Micro Asia, and Samsung C&T Corporation. The consortium has 18 months from the signing of the joint venture and development agreement, which will take place next month, to finalize the project's design and business plan. Sangli Airport will serve as an alternative to the congested Ninoy Aquino International Airport in Pasay City. The project was originally awarded to a consortium with China Communications Construction Company in 2019, but it was later on canceled by the province of Cavite.
Philippine tax collectors and justice officials square off over a proposal to create a national taxpayer advocate office. Juan Guzman with the details.
Senate Bill 1199, or the Taxpayers Bill of Rights and Obligations Act, has almost universal support for its goal to enshrine, codify, and inform the public of their rights and obligations as taxpaying citizens. Senator Sherwin Gachalian, principal author of the bill, says it is the responsibility of the government to help taxpayers understand their rights and what is expected of them.
These basic rights are already somehow present in various laws, various issuances, even our constitution. So the aim of this bill is to codify, to put all of those different rights and different obligations of the taxpayer in one single law.
There is one provision in the law, however, that proves to be problematic for stakeholders, including the Bureau of Internal Revenue and the Bureau of Customs, the government's main tax collection arms. It is a provision creating the National Taxpayer Advocate Office to be attached to the Department of Justice. The NTA is expected to serve a purpose similar to that of the Public Attorney's Office, to help taxpayers who cannot afford to hire tax firms for their tax cases.
The BIR is just of the position that the creation of a national tax office will indeed have a duplication in the function and work, which is actually being performed currently by the BIR.
The Bureau of Customs sided with the BIR, adding that providing the NTA with powers, including the ability to issue a stay order to halt tax assessment activities, may make it more difficult for them to fulfill their mandate of collecting revenues to fund government services and projects. Justice Undersecretary Raul Vasquez says he agrees with the BIR and BOC that the power to stop tax assessments might be too much, but the NTA still needs to have enough teeth to fulfill its purpose.
If we are to dilute the powers of the NTA and simply relegate it to an advisory function, it may lose its meaning and its purpose of being. We need to temper the powers that the Senate, that Congress may wish to grant unto it. But at the same time, we have to be aware as well that all the remedies mentioned by the BOC and the BIR are internal remedies.
The private sector was also divided on the matter. The Tax Management Association of the Philippines said that having been active in the formulation of SB 1199 through several Congresses now, they support it wholeheartedly. But the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry said if the new office would lead to duplication and possibly a more complex tax system, this would just make doing business in the Philippines more difficult. The Senate Committee on Ways and Means will hold a technical working group, tentatively set on September 22nd, to further discuss the matter. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.
The Fiscal Incentives Review Board offers a solution that would allow the continuation of a hybrid work setup for employees in the information technology and business process management sector. Finance Undersecretary Antoinette Tiongco says ITBPM firms registered with the Philippine Economic Zone Authority can register instead with the Board of Investments. This will allow them to enjoy the same fiscal incentives without being restricted to specific areas where they can operate. The board earlier warned PEZA registered firms they could lose their tax perks if their employees do not return to on-site work.